Hey everyone, this is Jyotika and welcome to your 12th HTML5 tutorial. Now that we know how to make lists and links, let's look at how we can combine them both to create a menu or a navigation bar. Let's say we want to make a main menu bar for our website, a section of links that we will use to navigate to other pages on our website. So I've created three links here, the words home, animals and movies. And I've wrapped each of them in an A element with the correct URL. And then I have wrapped each link in a LI element. This is a list of links. The whole list is wrapped in a UL element because the order of the links isn't that important. It's an unordered list. You can see how it looks on the right in the browser. And now, to indicate that this list is a navigation bar, I'm going to wrap the whole thing in a nav element. The nav element is for marking up navigation. It tells the browser which sets of links are a part of the site navigation. If you look in the browser, there isn't any visual change between how a list looked earlier and how a list wrapped in a nav element looks now, because the nav element does not add any formatting to your content. But it's a semantic element, and people using assistive devices like screen readers can use this element to decide what content on the page to initially skip or jump to on request. It adds the extra kind of importance that's conveyed to other people visually through styled navigation bars. You can style the navigation section to look any way you want using CSS. You can make it into a sidebar, navigation bar, or even a drop-down menu. Some of the most common examples of navigation sections are menus, tables of contents, or indexes. We are not going to go into the styling part in this tutorial. That will be covered when we learn about CSS. Now, one HTML document can contain several nav tags. For example, one for primary navigation around the site and one for secondary navigation within the page itself. So this example that we saw just now is a navigation between different web pages of our own website. And you can create another navigation section for navigating within the same page by wrapping the internal links in a nav element. Also, a nav element doesn't always have to contain a list. It can contain just the links, like in this example, or other kinds of content as well. In this navigation block, links are provided in prose. Another important thing to remember while using a nav element is that we shouldn't use it for all types of links. It must be used only for major blocks of navigational links. Our webpage here has several places where links are present, but only a few of those places are considered as navigation sections, like these across the site navigation links and these internal links for navigating through different sections on the same page. These links here are just links to some other websites, so they don't count as navigational links. And then we also have these kinds of links that can be found on the bottom of a page in the footer, like some contact info, terms of use, or privacy policy. The kind of links that aren't really part of a navigation or getting around the site. I've just marked up each link here as a link and wrapped them in a footer element. That's it. I don't want to use a nav element or even an unordered list. They are just some words linking to more content. So that's the nav element. A semantic element used only for major chunks of navigational links. It usually contains a list of links, but not always. There's not one right way to build it. It depends on the type of content you have. We have a lot of options when we start combining different HTML elements together. By thinking about the many actions and how they combine to give a semantic meaning to our content, we can start to make the right choices of HTML elements for our projects. If you would like to have the code for this entire web page, then I've put some links in the description below. So don't forget to check them out. Also, let me know in the comments if you have any questions. This is Jyotika signing off. Until next time, keep learning and keep coding.